Valley Christian Middle School Choral Concert in the Spring 2016 on June 1. I want to welcome everybody here. Before we go on, I just want to thank Ms. Struckmeyer for her conduct. A few weeks ago, I went to the cardiologist, and in checking out, the lady there said, "Okay, so what do you do for a living? What's your occupation?" I said, "I'm a middle school principal." And she went, "Oh." Now, if you want, what do you do for your work? "I conduct middle school boys choir." Okay? There's a challenge. And she has risen to the challenge. When I talked with her a year ago, I said, "Okay, you know, just go for it. Just stay one step ahead of everybody. Put your energy and heart into it. And they'll come right along with you." And that's pretty much what's happened. So thank you for being brave. Thank you for being talented. Thank you for all your investment in these kids. I'd like to read from Psalm 96. Because we're here not just for these kids, and we're not here just for her praises, but we're here for God's praises. This evening is His. So what we do here is this: sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Sing to the Lord, praise His name, proclaim His salvation day after day. Declare His glory among the nations, His marvelous deeds among all peoples. Great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. He is to be feared above all gods. That's why we're here, to give Him praise. That's why we sing. So when we listen to these kids, yeah, praise them later. Praise them in applause. That's good. But that's just all praise to the Lord. We're here for Him. And let's begin with prayer. Our Father in heaven, thank you for bringing us here together as brothers and sisters in Christ. And thank you, Lord, for these kids. These kids that love to sing. And you sing for joy as they praise you. We sing with them, or we hum and follow with them, but we join them in singing tonight as we praise you. So we ask for you to receive our praises, our time here of thanksgiving, and our fellowship, for it is all for the glory of God. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
All right, thank you guys so much for coming out. These students here have been working really hard on their music, and I am very excited for you to see how far they've come in just one semester of choir. I asked the men's ensemble earlier today, I said, how many of you guys feel like you've improved just in your personal voice in this last semester? I'm going to ask all of you guys that. How many of you feel more confident in your voice now? How many of you are actually excited to show these guys what you can do tonight? So I hope you enjoy. We're going to start with a combined number, as you can tell. This piece is kind of a demonstration of something we've been working on. It's something that we started after the first concert called Solfege, which is Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La, Ti, Do. If you wonder why we use solfege, why do we use these nonsense syllables? The reason is, numbers don't actually make a lot of sense in music. The distance between 2 and 3 is not the same between the distance between 3 and 4. 2 and 3 is a half, is a whole step. 3 and 4 is a half step. So the numbers can get really confusing. You can trick yourself into thinking something is an equal interval when it's not. Solfege teaches us to get the spaces and the intervals together more realistically in our mind. So this is a little demonstration of what we've been working on. And if you've seen The Sound of Music, you are probably familiar with this.
Thank you.
chorus is getting set. They will return later for their portion of the concert. We're going to go on with just our men's ensemble. Just our men's ensemble. Now this next piece, I can tell you, you are going to hear a variety of genres and styles throughout this concert. We've been talking a little bit about different kinds of music, so you're going to hear some traditional choral pieces. You heard one Broadway piece already. You're going to hear some more show tunes. You're going to hear some folk songs, and you're even going to hear a pop piece later on. This next piece is called Rest Not by Laura Farnell, and it is based on a poem called A Psalm of Life by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow. And it's a poem about reaching for your dreams, particularly if you have a desire to make an impact on the world around you. So here is Rest Not.
Shady Grove.
traditional choral works. This next piece is called Benedictus. It is a Latin text, which is actually your guys' first... Are we okay? No, follow down. Was this your first foreign piece, your first non-English text?
Yeah.
This is the first non-English text. It is in Latin. And it translates as, "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed, blessed. Hosanna in the highest."
Thank you.
for the band. I don't know how many of you have experience getting up and singing in front of people, but it can be quite terrifying when you have all those people staring at you. But they, like I said, worked so hard, and I'm very proud of everything that you guys have done. So thank you very much for all the work that you've put into this. And next ensemble, next choir, Europe. Our first piece is going to be another Latin piece. This is called Et in Terra Pax. And it translates the words as, "And on earth, peace and goodwill among men. Give thanks to God. We praise you. We bless you. We adore you. We glorify you. Grant us peace."
Against the pretty sand, probably getting gorgeously tanned.
I really can't. It seems like they walked in my classroom 2 days ago. And I have to say goodbye to people, but it's so amazing. We are going to shift gears a little bit again. This song is By the Waters, and it is from the perspective of Israel when they were in Babylonian captivity. So it's a very emotional song, because the time in Babylon was not a very positive experience, to say the very least. The Israelites suffered a lot, including the deaths of their children, very hard conditions, and they waited throughout all this time knowing that sometime they would return to Jerusalem, they would return to Zion. So this piece is the Israelites as they are waiting and longing for that day. Alright, hang tight for about 60 seconds and then there's ice cream.